So you're 16 and you want to start your own Shopify dropshipping business. But first of all, congratulations that you've taken this decision and you want to embark upon this amazing journey. And it's going to be a journey that's not only going to be about Shopify dropshipping, but in the process, you're going to acquire a lot of skills at such an early age and develop a mindset of entrepreneurship and of being a business person, whether you're a man or a woman, whether you're a boy or a girl, I should say. So if you're like 14, 15, 16 or 17 years old, that is you're basically like a minor and you want to start your own Shopify dropshipping business, watch this video closely because I'm going to give you some pointers on how to approach this effectively. Now listen, in my audience, like I have received a lot of comments over the past several months from people who actually watched my videos and then started their own business, who were like 14 to 17 year olds and who were actually doing pretty well with their business in the comments. I used to be so happy learning about people who used to just start up their business watching my videos and then they made it, they started earning a good amount of pocket money and then they even scaled their business. Some of them are actually running like good profitable businesses. So how is it possible? Like, how can you actually start your own business if you're like a 14 to 17 year old? So here's the thing. I started off when I was 18. All right. So even though I was dabbling with some online technologies, internet technologies when I was like 17 years old, I actually didn't start earning till I was like 17. And by that time, I actually just had my own PAN card and things were a lot more, even though like we did not have access to a lot of information. So it used to take a lot of time to actually Google and research through a lot of different stuff just to figure out small, tiny aspects of web development, of design, because I used to be a freelancer at that point. So nowadays, things are a lot different. Like those days we didn't have like iPhones and you know iPads and you know the internet was pretty slow. We used to be like on a modem connection, so it used to be 56 kbps, something like that, old compact machines, and you know it used to be a challenge to actually just find out information and learn from things. Nowadays 4G is here, super fast internet speeds. Not just that, like information is so readily accessible. So if you want to learn about strategies, about techniques, if you basically want to learn how to do business, there's just so much free information out there that all you need to do is actually just invest your time and set up a mindset where you just want to learn and then execute stuff. So in this video, I'm going to break down certain aspects of what you should do and how you should approach this business if you're a 14 to 17 year old. So keep watching till the end. Now, the first thing you have to remember is that you're starting off at an amazing, amazing age. Now, because you're young, like you have the entire life ahead of you, and you'll in this process of like starting your own and running your business, you'll actually learn things about like taking decisions, taking responsibility, making choices, whether it's hard or you know easy. Sometimes you're going to face some challenges, then overcoming those challenges. Your mindset is going to get developed at such an early age that it's going to help you a lot in your future career, and you might actually be, you know, just kill it when you're like 30 or 40 years old. Like you might have like a huge business by then. So it's actually pretty good age to start, but only if you start off on the right foot and with the right mindset. Now think about this. At that kind of age, you don't really have that many responsibilities, especially as you're living with your parents and your parents are doing well and you have your own house, like where you're staying, and you don't really have that many responsibilities. For most people, it's just the days are passed by just attending school and then playing PUBG or doing some random things, hanging out with friends and whatnot, eating food and then sleeping. So if you actually have a shift of your mindset, you'll realize that you have a lot of free time, right? So, and a question that I get quite often is that like whether I should quit school or college or then I should just put all my focus into this business. I'll be honest with you, I'll give you the answer in this video, and the answer is no. So when I started, I was still in college. I was in my second year of engineering. So when I started, and I realized pretty quickly that you only have like 24 hours in a day, but when you're not doing something productive, those 24 hours can go away pretty quickly, and you can end up wasting weeks, months and years not being productive, not doing anything. But when you're at that age and if you really look closely, like you only have a few hours of like a study time that you have and then a few hours of school or college time, and the rest of the day is basically free. right? Just look back at your routine for the past like several weeks. Like, have you really been putting effort into being productive or creating something of your own or doing something that might actually generate you income, right? If you're not, then you'll realize that you actually have a lot of free time. Most people don't realize this, but time is your most valuable friend. And if you can use it effectively, you can get good things done in that small amount of time. So what I recommend is just attend your school, college, do your study sessions, do everything else, but also focus a little bit of your time. And when you're in that focus, where you're spending a few hours every day on your business, that's what you're doing. Like, that should be your 100% focus. You're not thinking about playing games. You're not thinking about hanging out with friends. Let others do what they're doing. Because see, in the end, becoming an entrepreneur and becoming a business person is a lot about secluding yourself from the what will people say mentality, right? So there are going to be so many people out there. Most of them are going to end up either doing jobs, and doing job is not really bad if that's what you want to do. But if you want to do business, then you'll realize that you're in a minority of people. So when you're in that minority, things can get pretty tough because people don't understand what you're doing. And you have to explain to people what you're doing. Don't think about all of that, all right? All you have to think about is just taking out those few hours and focusing completely without any distractions on just the things you need to do that very day. And since you don't have that many responsibilities, so you don't really have to spend, you don't really need to earn like tens of thousands of dollars. Like, you don't need to pay any EMIs on cars or houses. You don't have that much stress on you. So it's actually a perfect age to get your mentality and your business off, getting it off the ground. So if you're able to do that properly, then you're going to be in a much, much better position when you actually become an adult, when you cross 18 years old, and when you start having those responsibilities of taking care of family, of taking care of your loved ones. So then you'll have a good corpus also with you, so that you'll be able to easily transition into that sort of adulthood. So what should be your strategy if you're 14 to 17 years old and you want to start your own dropshipping business? Well, I'm going to break it down into a few parts. The first is going to be the setup. Now, in setup, you of course have company that you have to form, a PayPal account, like setting up a Shopify store and whatnot. And most of it can actually be done with the help of your parents. Now, it might be your parents might take a little bit of, you might need to convince. And listen, most parents won't really understand, but you have to actually sit down with them, lock the door, and then actually explain to them what you plan to do and show them a business plan. Like, literally write it down, create a business plan that this is what you want to do, these are your financial goals, these are your like revenue numbers you want to hit, and what kind of store you'll be building, what kind of products you'll be adding, because you'll have done all the research already. So you'll be in a much better position to actually bring out that business plan, explain it to them, and they'll be also, because you'll be explaining it in a much better way, they'll understand and they'll help you out. So all you need is like a company, either a sole proprietorship or like a partnership firm or a private limited one person company, whatnot. And your parents can actually form that. And in many cases, what can happen is that your parents can actually make you the authorized signatory for that company. So for all official documents of that company, you can become the authorized signatory. So you can start taking those official decisions of that company, even though your parents own that company. And in the future, let's say like when you turn 18 or 19 and you want to start your own company, let's say your store is running for the past several years, you can easily transition it. You basically were the authorized signatory, your parents were the owner of the previous company. So basically you create a new company when you become an adult and your store will become part of that company with a new PayPal account, right? So the transition process, don't think that much into it. Your goal should be basically to just set things up the right way so that you're at least you start off on your path. Like, a lot of people just get stuck on like GST and your company formation. So if you're stuck on that, just watch my previous video. Just search for company formation flying start online in YouTube. You're going to find several videos where I talk about company formation and how to start it up. And I also talk about like payment gateways. The same applies for like a PayPal account. In order to open up a PayPal account, you need a PAN number, either a company's PAN number or your personal PAN number. And since you'll be a minor, you won't have that. So your parents' PAN number can be applied. Or when your parents create a company, that company can acquire a PAN number and that PAN number will be applied to the PayPal account, and there you'll get started. I know it's a little bit of work, but guys, listen, nothing in life is going to come easy. When you have to pass, let's say a semester, or when you have to pass exams for the entire year, let's say your board exams, you need to study hard. You need to put in a lot of hours, a lot of effort. Do you actually crib? I know a lot of people crib at that point, but just inculcate the attitude and the spirit of facing the challenges that you have, one challenge at a time, solving that challenge so that you are able to move forward. Don't stop. Don't stop when you face a challenge. That's the only thing. Don't give up, right? So the next thing that you want to focus on is learning. All right, so the first was setup. You got everything set up. And what can happen is that that company can actually create a current account. So you have a bank account, you have a debit card. So you have all the basics set up, right? The next part is actually learning. So how do you learn about this business? And as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, like nowadays information is so easily accessible, and that too for free. You don't even need to pay for information nowadays. Just go watch my Bizathon 3, 4, 5, and 6 series. Just watch all the videos in there. Spend like, just binge watch all of them so that like in a week or 2 weeks, you'll basically have a complete understanding of how the business works and what your approach should be with it. Now, even though you have the learning, the next part that I want to talk about, which is the third point. So first was setup, the second was learning, and the third, once you have that knowledge, the third is acquiring your skills. Okay, and skills are what will take you forward. Skills are what will make you a master, a pro, and put you in a great position when you actually become an adult or when you're actually 25 years old. So it's going to, these skills that you acquire right now at such an early age, so you're going to have, your brain is always working because you're attending school and college. I remember like my IQ used to be the highest at that point. So because at that point you're already involved in like a learning process and an execution process. So it's much more easier to acquire those skills at an early age and then keep growing from there. So do spend some time on acquiring these skills that you need to run a dropshipping business. Things like image editing, just use Canva. Things like video editing, just download some video editing software. Just try editing some videos on your own, music and cuts and whatnot. And the more you keep doing it, the better you'll keep getting at it. Try content writing, like for product descriptions, for ad copy and whatnot. So when you do it like 100 times, you'll of course be much better than when you started off. So when you acquire those skills, all of these are going to come handy in your business, of course, but they're going to put you in a much better position going forward in the future also. And the fourth thing I want to talk about is money. And that is where a lot of people get stuck, right? So what if I don't have money to invest in this business? Now, apart from like the Shopify subscription fees and some small expenses right there, which I believe are not much. So they're not, those little expenses shouldn't be a hindrance. $29 a month shouldn't be a hindrance for you. The biggest hindrance that people will have about money is basically investing into, plane is flying over it, but the biggest hindrance that people will have about money is going to be like about Facebook ads, right? Because you need a budget for it. Now I know there are going to be people, let's say, who are watching this, who are 14 to 17 year olds, who have actually either done like freelancing jobs in the past, or they're doing freelancing currently, or they have a source of income, they have a source of pocket money. Maybe you're working some part-time jobs while going to school. That's awesome. So if you have that sort of capital and you want to invest, well, that's great. So in that case, what you want to do is you want to watch my Bizathon 7 series. So that's going to be like, it's about 26, 27 videos where I completely break down like how to run Facebook ads the right way moving forward in 2019. And also recently I published a video on the tuber method, which is like 2 or 3 videos before this video. So you can watch that video where I explain like how you should approach your calculations when it comes to like calculating your break even and your profit margins and whatnot. So having all of this knowledge will actually help you. The second case of people is going to people who don't have money, right? So if you have absolutely nothing apart from like the Shopify subscription fees, let's say you don't have like $500 or $1,000 to invest in Facebook ads, what do you do then? Well, in that case, what you want to do is you want to invest your time. And that is going to be a much, it's going to take a lot of time. So when you have money, it's much more easier because you can just keep dumping money into ads. And then when you find a winner, you can easily scale it. But for those people who don't have money, and I can actually understand that because I come from a place where I didn't have any money. I started with absolutely zero investment in my business when I was 18 years old. I built it up slowly over time. And all I did was just invest my time. I kept putting in all the time I could, and then I started building a business. And that these same principles apply to like Shopify dropshipping also. So when you're Shopify dropshipping, what you need to do is invest your time into building like social profiles, regularly posting content, building up a following, a fan base in the niche of your products that you want to advertise from your store, and then start advertising from your products to that audience, whether it's like Pinterest or Instagram or Facebook or Snapchat. There's so many social platforms out there, even YouTube, right? You know, start creating YouTube videos and then pitch your e-com products. You know how many people sell merchandise? All these big YouTubers, all of them sell merch, right? What are these? These are all e-com stores. So you can sell a lot of like stuff when it comes to like when you have an audience, it becomes much more easier to sell stuff. The second thing you want to do is actually spend some time on like writing good product descriptions, optimizing your page, optimizing your store so that you get good rankings in the search engines, doing product keyword research and putting in like sprinkling in your keywords inside your product description, interlinking your site so that it's all effective. Now SEO is a whole beast altogether, so I won't get into the complete details of it, but a lot of people run their Shopify businesses not with paid traffic but with organic traffic. Now it does take a while to build up, but once it does, like it's amazing, like how organic traffic works is pretty amazing, right? So I've actually had some of my most successful websites that got traffic from like Google, and then they went on to make a lot of money for me. So you can actually build up your Shopify store completely just for SEO. So you're writing good quality content in your product descriptions, you're optimizing your pages, you're on page, you're building backlinks, a lot of things, so that your SEO is on point. So when people search for a particular product, your store comes up, and then you start making money. So that is of course a $0 investment strategy, and that you can try out as well. In order to learn more about SEO, just Google it, man. Just Google e-commerce SEO, how to do e-commerce SEO, how to write product descriptions for SEO. You can type in all sorts of keywords like this. You'll find all sorts of results. Do your research, read blog posts, watch videos, follow the SEO experts out there, learn from them, and then apply it in your e-commerce store, right? And whatever concepts I've told you right now, they don't only apply to like 14 to 17 year old. Let's say you're like 19, 20 or 21 year old. Then apart from like the company formation aspect, but all of the other things I talked about, they still apply to you, right? So I hope that like this kind of plan that I've laid out for you is helpful for you. Now my request would be, like, I know a lot of 14 to 17 year olds are in my audience. So if you're somebody who's actually made it with a Shopify store or who are actually getting sales and you're in that age group, just help out people in the comments below, because I know that after watching this, some people are going to have questions and more. They would need more information about how to get things done. So it would be amazing if you guys could actually have a chat, help each other out, maybe even, hey, partner up and build your own combined stores together. That'll be awesome, right? My goal is to help you guys and give you guys the push. I hope this was helpful for you. If this was, smash the like button below and make sure you subbed and belled to the Flying Start Online channel. This was Rito, and I'll see you in the next video. Until next time, okay, tata, bye bye.